Thank you, Bill. Before we get started, I have a quick announcement. Somebody is driving a Jetta with license plate HMW1165. If you'd please move your car, you're parked in the condo association parking space. So if you'd be so kind as to move into one of the church parking spaces, that'll be awesome. Please arise as you're able. Join with me in singing, "Lord, I lift your name on high." Lord, I lift your name on high. Lord, I love to sing your praises. I'm so glad you're in my life. I'm so glad you came to save us. You came from heaven to earth to show the way, from the earth to the cross, my debt to pay. From the cross to the grave, from the grave to the sky, Lord, I lift your name on high. Lord, I lift your name on high. Lord, I love to sing your praises. I'm so glad you're in my life. I'm so glad you came to save us. You came from heaven to earth to show the way, from the earth to the cross, my debt to pay. From the cross to the grave, from the grave to the sky, Lord, I lift your name on high. Lord, I lift your name on high. Lord, I lift your name on high.
Here, thank you. You may be seated. We are here today to lift love's name up high, and also to receive that love inside. If this is your first time at MCCDC, my name's Pastor Dwayne, the senior pastor. My honor and privilege to welcome you. I also bring you greetings today from Reverend Kathy Alexander, our associate pastor. She is catching her breath today. So Reverend Kathy, if you're on live stream, we love you and good morning. And good morning to all who are on live stream today. I would invite you to take a moment to look at your card that's inside the worship folder today. This is the pastoral care card. Every week, the prayers are compiled, and our pastoral care ministers pray for each prayer request every single week. So we invite you to take a moment to fill out this card so that we can be in touch with you and in prayer for you and with you. We'd invite you now to take a moment to check your cell phones to make sure they're on silent, but do keep them on so you can send out a text message to someone and let them know that God loves them and that MCCDC is the place to
be.
You were on that. 9 o'clock in the morning and you were right on that. That is great. We invite you now to arise as you're able. Introduce yourself to someone you may not know as we continue in worship.
Thank you.
Please remain standing. Take out your hymnal as you return to your seats. Turn to page number 52. There is a name I love to hear, or Oh, How I Love Jesus. You may know it by that name. Number 52. There is a name I love to hear, I love to sing its worth. It sounds like music to my ear, the sweetest name on earth. Oh, how I love Jesus. Oh, how I love Jesus. Oh, how I love Jesus, whose love has first found me. It tells my Savior's love for all. Christ died to set us free. Whatever problems may befall, we'll live in dignity. Oh, how I love Jesus. Oh, how I love Jesus. Oh, how I love Jesus, whose love has first found me. It bids me serve amid the wrath God's people face each day, and sheds along life's troubled path bright sunshine on my way. Oh, how I love Jesus. Oh, how I love Jesus. Oh, how I love Jesus, whose love has first found me. One more time.
Oh, how I love Jesus, who's right there. We just have to remember, and I do most of the time, but one of the things I want to just pray about this morning briefly is to have Jesus, have God, have the Holy Spirit, have even more presence in my life. And I pray for that, not because God needs to show up more, but because I need to show up more. So when we have a song like this, this beautiful, wonderful thing that just reminds us of the depth of God's love and Jesus' love for us, well, I just come this morning in gratitude. Gratitude for that. And let us just take a moment as we sit here to be quiet and just reflect briefly on the presence of God in our lives and the love of Jesus, who is with us every moment of our lives. There's no time God is not, Jesus is not, no place God or Jesus or the Holy Spirit are not. They're always present, not just in church. So we give thanks to God. And we say, God, thank you. Thank you, God, for all that you give us and the ways that you show us to love one another and the opportunity in church, but every other place to continue to love you. So as we have service today and as we are together, let us give thanks. Let us be filled with all that comes our way today, and to know that God will take everything that we have received and help us make it more. Help us love the world. So Jesus, we love you. We love you so much. We're here because we love you, and of course we're here because you love us. Oh my, such love. There is none like it. So let us feel the blessing, let us bask in the love, and let us give thanks. In Jesus' name, and in all your holy names.
John 14:15-21. If you love me, you will keep my commandments. I will ask the one who sent me to give you another companion, another helper, to be with you forever. This companion is the Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot accept, since the world neither sees her nor recognizes her. But you can recognize the Spirit, because she remains with you and will be within you. I will not leave you orphaned. I will come back to you. A little while now, and the world will see me no more. But you'll see me, because I live, and you will live as well. On that day, you'll know that I am in God, and you are in me, and I am in you. Those who obey my commandments are the ones who love me, and those who love me will be loved by Creator God. I too will love them and will reveal myself to them.
Great is the Lord and most worthy of praise. In the city of our God, the holy place, the joy of the whole earth. Great is the Lord in whom we have the victory, who aids us against the enemy. We bow down on our knees, and Lord, we want to lift your name on high. And Lord, we want to thank you for the works you've done in our lives. And Lord, we trust in your unfailing love. For you alone are God eternal throughout the earth and heaven above. Great is the Lord and most worthy of praise. In the city of our God, the holy place, the joy of the whole earth. Great is the Lord in whom we have the victory, who aids us against the enemy. We bow down on our knees, and Lord, we want to lift your name on high. And Lord, we want to thank you for the works you've done in our lives. And Lord, we trust in your unfailing love. For you alone are God eternal throughout the earth and heaven above. Lord, we trust in your unfailing love. For you alone are God eternal throughout the earth and heaven above.
Amen. It takes great courage to live the spiritual life. And now more than ever, we are called to live from the spiritual depths. We are called to be a people who offer spiritual proactivity as well as spiritual resistance to the forces we face today, the forces that so easily could overtake our souls. Today we are called to be a people of courage, just as Jesus' disciples were called to courage. In our scripture today, their courage was wavering. Their courage was wavering because Jesus said he was going to leave them, and they'd signed up to follow him, not to have him then leave them. They are afraid. And so Jesus offers them and us a very important message, a message about spiritual resolve and spiritual courage. We live in troubled times, and Jesus offers us a word. What Jesus says, first of all, is that even in an unloving world, it is so important that you hold out for love with every breath you have. Keep on loving, Jesus says, even when you face the unloving on so many levels. In John 14:15, he says to his disciples, if you love me, you will keep my commandments. And what is the command? To love. Quite simply, Jesus is saying, if you love me, love. Even when love does not initially come back to you. Love God with all your heart, soul, mind, and strength, and love your neighbor as yourself. Jesus knew that the only thing greater than the threat of empire in their time was the force of love. And the only thing greater than the forces of oppression we face is also the force of love. Love force, soul force, courage from the inside out. Love through all seasons and all times. Love even when it seems you are losing. The disciples were losing Jesus. They couldn't understand what was happening. And many in our day feel like they have lost their voice. We do have Jesus who invites us to listen to the inner voice that's stronger than the outer voice. Even in the face of loss, we can keep on loving. How do we face the losses of our lives? We draw on that inner courage. I'm inspired by many who have turned their losses into love through great courage. I think of Mothers Against Drunk Driving who turned the grief of loss into the courage to work for change. I think of the Matthew Shepherd Foundation. It's a force for love with the courage to face hate crimes. And I think of those today who pretty much every weekend or more are offering resistance to the forces around us. Those who have the courage to go and stand in front of the White House even when they are tired in their bodies and their feet. I am grateful for those who continue to offer a voice of love and hope even during this time. And I'm thankful for those witnesses who have gone before us who shows us what it means to live with courage. I think of the Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. and those who marched, those who fought for civil rights in our country. They are our models for how we're called to respond in this day when so many rights are being taken away. I'm thankful that we have a God who calls us to voice our courage. Black lives matter. I'm thankful for a God who calls us to voice our courage. God does not create illegal people. I am thankful for a God who calls us to be courageous. Recently, I read this wonderful new bestseller on the spiritual life of Eleanor Roosevelt. And she's one who turned her losses into courage. She's one who, with the loss of her parents, one who, with the loss of so many in her family, and one who was in a loveless marriage, chose to fight and be courageous anyway. She brought hope to the oppressed by facing racist and political oppression with word and action. She spoke and she acted. She says, "You gain strength, courage, and confidence by every experience in which you really stop to look fear in the face. You're able to say to yourself, I have lived through this horror, so I can take the next thing that comes along." And then she says this powerful quote, "You must do the thing you think you cannot do." Is there anything you're facing today that you think you cannot face? Are you called to do something that you think you cannot do? Jesus invites you to draw on that inner courage, that inner voice of love, that force on the inside of each one of us that is greater than the forces on the outside. If our mind is stayed on fear, then fear has become our God. God is not a fearful God. God is a God of hope and courage and life. Fear is not our God. How do we do the thing we think we cannot do? Through the courage that comes through the Holy Spirit, who's described in our scripture today as the divine companion. Let's go deeper with that thought. This divine companion is one who goes alongside us and is also one who is inside us. Let's think first about the divine companion that's alongside us. When Jesus extends a call, he expects us to fulfill that call, yet not by ourselves. So Jesus made it clear to the disciples that they were not standing alone in their call to courage. So he bolstered them with a promise. Jesus said, "I will ask the one who sent me to give you another advocate, another helper to be with you forever." Jesus was the first advocate, calling them, standing with them, showing them the power of God through his own heart and his hands. But now Jesus promises another helper, the paraclete, the companion. Jesus loves those he has called to love. Jesus loves the lovers. So he does not invite them to walk alone, but to walk together with each other and also with the active presence of the Holy Spirit, the divine companion. This is an active presence right alongside us. That's why it's important to be still and know that God is God. When we're still, we can sense that presence of God alongside us. We can sing the song, "I want Jesus to walk with me." Jesus still walks with us and moves with us and goes with us through this Spirit alongside us. We have the courage to do the next right thing. We have the courage to do what we think we cannot do when we draw on that companion, that Spirit walking right alongside us. We also have the courage to love through the strength of this divine companion who's not only alongside us, but also inside us. In verse 20, Jesus says, "Know that I am in God, and you are in me, and I am in you." What a powerful flow of thought. Jesus is in God, and we are in Jesus, and Jesus is in us through the Spirit. It means that we have exactly what we need, and we carry what we need with us. We don't have to go grabbing for it, striving for it, competing for it. In this competitive world, we have a Spirit that is in us. I love a phrase used by Jamie Clark Soles, a theologian. He says it's not the Trinity, it's the quatrinity. God the Creator, Jesus Christ the Savior, the Holy Spirit, and us. God in us. The quatrinity that is able to be a force for good in this world. Jesus invites us to both unity and intimacy with God, and we are invited into that intimacy. The one who listens to us listens within us. Be still and know that I am God, and therein find your courage and your strength. In this current season of disquiet, where do we go to be quiet and know that God is God? We just go right here and here. We have what we need to live a courageous life. Oh, Jesus makes it so clear. Live the love-shaped life rather than the fear-shaped life. I invite you to ask yourself a question this week at the end of each day as part of your spiritual practice. Ask this question: in what ways was I courageous today? And then note those. And then look at the day coming and ask God to give you the courage to face the next day, to do what you think you cannot do. Julian of Norwich, like the James. And she said this: I know that at times I will be belabored. I know that at times I will be disquieted. But I believe that I will not be overcome. That is the good news of our gospel today. Jesus gave those early disciples courage. Jesus gave Eleanor Roosevelt courage. Jesus gave Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. courage. Jesus gave all of those who stand outside the White House today courage. Jesus gives us what we need to live the loving and courageous life. Amen and amen. Amen. Jesus found his courage when he was baptized. He found his courage in the voice from heaven that said, "You are my own, my beloved, with you I am well pleased." So baptism is about being born again, renewed and refreshed. It's also about hearing that voice that calls us to love and courage. We also offer for you here today this oil and laying on of hands. In ancient times, the balm in Gilead, the healing presence. This oil also reminds us of that spirit, that companion that goes with us, that walks alongside us and lives within us. During this time of response, think about where you need courage in your life today and draw on that inner voice of love. Please rise as you're able as the pastoral care ministers come to offer support and prayers.
I am number 207. Just as I am without one plea, but that your blood was shed for me, and that you called inviting me, O Lamb of God, I come. Just as I am, though tossed about with many a conflict, many a doubt, fightings and fears within, without, O Lamb of God, I come. Just as I am, you will receive, will welcome, pardon, cleanse, relieve, because your promise I believe, O Lamb of God, I come.
We come, you are right there. You are always waiting for us. Your heart is always open. You know what we need even before we ask, and yet you love it when we ask because you just want to be with us. You want to hold us throughout the night. You want to whisper your love words to us throughout the day. Slow us down that we might know that you are our God. And therein find all that we need to love courageously and hopefully and openly and with vulnerability. We praise you. We thank you. You are our God. Amen. 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 When we take our membership vows, one of the things we do is we agree to support our church and the vision of our church with our time and our talents and our financial resources. And so today we have one who supports the church in so many powerful and loving ways. Dre, if you could come forward at this time. We are so grateful for the ministry that God has called you to do as our worship coordinator for 9 a.m. and 11 a.m. It's like herding cats, and you do a beautiful job with that. And you make the cats look good. You look in the back, they're always beautifully organized. So just share a little bit from your heart about how God is giving you the courage to serve and to minister in so many ways. Let's make sure this is on. I think it is. Is this on? We'll see if it's on.
Okay. Thank you, Pastor. Hello?
Push it hard, maybe. Okay, try again. Hello? Hello?
Hello? Hello?
Which microphone do you want us to use?
This one's on.
Okay. You heard the one about how many MCCDCers it takes to dot, dot, dot. So, good.
Thank you. Good morning, everyone.
Thank you.
So I was asked a few years ago, would I help out ushering? And I said yes. And now I am the coordinator for the ushers for 9 and 11 o'clock service. I didn't know I was going to be doing it so long, but I enjoy doing it. And I enjoy doing it. It's service, and it's service for MCCDC, service for God, and I enjoy doing it. And one of the things I remember years ago when I went to another church and I was welcomed, it was the greatest feeling. It was the first time at that church, and I want to provide the same thing here at MCCDC. The first line of people that you see, when others come to the door, they see the ushers. And so I look forward to greeting people, hello, letting people feel welcome. This is the place to be, and so that's what I do on Sunday. So I am asking, because we're in need of ushers. We're so much in need of ushers. The same ushers have been doing it for years and years and years. And so we need help for the 9 o'clock and the 11 o'clock. So if you would consider in just helping out your church, just helping us out. You don't have to do it every month. We have schedules where folks do it once per month or as needed, so you can do as needed if you feel so. So if you could help us, I'd appreciate it. I love doing it, I enjoy doing it, and I love welcoming people, so that's why I do it.
Thank you so much. Let's give a word of thanks to Dre. Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you so much. And Dre does just an amazing job. She looks for things that need to be done even before being asked to do them, and that's part of the joy. And so it's a great ministry for someone perhaps who travels in and is not here during the week and just really has time on Sundays to do this on an occasional basis. And one of the side benefits is you get to work with Dre, and you can see how wonderful she is from what she shared today. We thank you, God, for the opportunity to love and to serve and to be your people. We now ask that you would bless all the gifts that we bring. Bless our time. Multiply it for your purpose. Bless our talents. Help us to always use the talents you've given us. And bless these financial resources that they might bring more love into this world. We thank you. Amen.
Our offertory hymn is number 565, God Whose Giving Knows No Ending. Please rise as you're able. We're going to sing the first and last stanza, number 565.
Offering up ourselves in prayer.
may be seated. Christ our Lord invites all to this table, this celebration, as at all metropolitan community churches around the world, is open to each of you. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks and praise to the Lord.
It is right to give God thanks and praise.
Blessed are you, Lord God, creator and sovereign of the universe. You love the world so much that you gave your only Son, Jesus Christ, to be our Savior. He suffered and died for the sins of the world so that we may have new life in him. Therefore, we join all your people throughout the ages and the whole company of heaven as we offer this hymn of praise, saying, Holy, 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 Lord God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
Let us pray. I invite you, dear ones, to bring your hunger and thirst for all God has for you, for us, for the hope, faith, trust, joy, depth, love that only God can provide. All that Jesus offers to us, to feed us without limits. Our part is to come in honest need, with open hearts and minds and mouths and ears, to receive all that God has for us, and open hands to both receive and to give away all we receive. Send the power of your Holy Spirit on us and on these gifts, and awaken in us the depths and power of your love, that in the breaking of this bread and the drinking of this cup, our hunger, our thirst be satisfied, and we may know the presence of Jesus, the presence of the living Christ in every moment of our lives. Amen. Amen. And we remember that on that night long ago, gathered in that upper room with his faithful companions, the ones who were still learning but continuing to show up and be with him, that he took the bread at that Passover meal, and he gave thanks to you, God, for it, and he blessed it, and he broke it, saying to them, as he says to us, this is my life broken open for you, that you might receive all that you need and use it to glorify God. And after the bread, he took the cup, and again he gave thanks to you for it and blessed it and said to them, as he says to us, this is my life poured out for you, that you might drink of it, that you might take it in every part of your being, every part of your soul, every part of your body, and it might touch you and raise you up and give you strength and hope and love to share, to go forth in my name to heal the world. And he said to them, as again he says to us, whenever you eat of this bread and drink of this cup, remember me. Remember my call to you. Remember the strength of God. And go forth. Amen. So, knowing that that mystery of faith is here again with us today, let us join together and proclaim it with these words. Christ has risen. Christ has risen. Christ will come again.
Hallelujah.
And I'm going to take a liberty here. Some churches that I know say one additional phrase, and I like it. I just want to bring it up today, I think. We say, Christ has died, Christ has risen, Christ is here, Christ will come again. Amen. So, my dear ones, come and receive the gifts of God for you and all of us everywhere, because we're all the people of God. Amen.
Our first communion hymn is number 506, What a Friend We Have in Jesus, number 506. Number 473, Blessed Assurance, 473.
Submission all
watching and waiting, looking above, filled with God's goodness, lost in Christ's love. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. Perfect submission, all is at rest. I and my Savior am happy and blessed, watching and waiting, looking above, filled with God's goodness, lost in Christ's love. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. Blessed assurance, Jesus is mine. Oh, what a
we give thanks that you, Holy God, have fed us in these holy mysteries of bread and cup given by the living Christ. That as we go forth in days to come, we shall remember to return to you again and again, knowing it is you who feed us, and wanting to feel full of your hope and love and joy and trust and faith, and to be moved and empowered to share the bounty in our hearts given to us by you with those we meet, and indeed to share with a hungry, needy world. In Jesus' name, amen. Please rise as you are able and join in singing the prayer Jesus taught us.
And forgive us our our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen.
Amen. I invite you to be seated just for a moment while we cover a few highlights. I do invite you to check out the flat screen in the welcome hall for some information, our website, www.mccdc.com. We also have a few highlights in our worship folder. I'm just going to cover a few of them, so you do want to read it. If you see on page 5, coming up this Saturday, it's the old school party and dance with a purpose. This is to help support Mary House, one of our partner organizations. They have an office here. Many of our members are involved with Mary's House. It's providing a place for older adults to be able to live their retirement years with joy and with connection and with community and with home. Page 6, you will see that it is Pride season. It is happening fast. So look at those. You'll see which ones you're available to participate in. Page 7, one of our beloved members, Hal Crawford, a faithful attender of this service and our worship ministry. His service, memorial service, is this Wednesday at 1:30 p.m. here at MCCDC. His sister is coming in from Georgia. Our pastor in Wilmington, North Carolina, is coming to be a part of the service as well. There will be a repast, and so we do invite you, if you're able, to come and remember the life of Hal Crawford, one who has an ongoing legacy with us. And then today, if you see on page 10, I am preaching not only here at MCCDC at 9 and 11, but am preaching for the 45th anniversary service at MCC Baltimore today. So yes, prayers for the feet. The soul is strong, but the souls are going to be a little bit rough by the time we get there, so we do ask for your prayers. We want to say a special, special thank you to Eclectic Praise, who is going with me to minister at MCC Baltimore today, so prayers for Eclectic Praise as well. They'll be doing 3 pieces, so it's going to be a wonderful celebration. I saw that Bill and Mark, who were here at 9 today, have already gone to rest up to go to Baltimore. So if you are up for an excursion today, join us at MCC Baltimore, information on page 10. This is the day that our God has made, so let us continue to rejoice in it with our closing song.
Our closing hymn is number 26, We Worship You, God. We're going to sing the first and fifth stanza, first and last, number 26.
Time of hospitality and refreshment, we would remind you that before you speak with someone you know well, speak with someone who you don't know well or someone who you don't know, so that we can become the friendly congregation that we seek to be. And now from this place today, hear again the words of Saint Elmore. You must do the thing you think you cannot do. With courage, go from this place today to minister love in this world. In the name of God, our Creator, Jesus Christ, our Savior, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.